And I'll invite Muralidhar Krishna Reddy to go with his presentation.
Hello, everyone. Today, we would like to talk about our product called TTAKTILE. It's a Reggio-inspired learning pre-product. I'm Muralidhar. I'm from CMR University, Bangalore. And my co-author is Ritu Sonalika from the Shrishti School of Art, Design and Technology. So we would like to take our presentation in the following process, where we explain the need for experiential learning and talk about the project, the client brief, the Reggio Emilia system, what design approach we've taken, and we'll talk about our product, TTAKTILE, and then what are the secondary systems that have been developed along with the primary product. We'll talk about the environment and the conclusions. So why do we need experiential learning for our children? Now, in the words of Loris Malaguzzi, children need the freedom to appreciate the infinite resources of their hands, their eyes, and their ears, the resources of forms, materials, sounds, and colors. And then in words of Aristotle, for the things we have to learn to before we can do them, we learn by doing them. Now, this paper, we had completed this project in 2017. And the paper itself was a pre-COVID-19 work. And we have gone through the pandemic, and we now more than enough understand the importance of experiential learning, since the kind of time we went through. Now, why do we need it for our children again? Especially in today's urban society, there's a lot of lack of physical activity. We have excess exposure to digital tools, exposure to pollution, we lack of slowness in everyday activities. And of course, the most important one is lack of face-to-face social skills, just to name a few. But what does this lead to? Lack of experiential learning, it leads to obesity, sleep disturbance, we have attention problems, and whatever the kids look at in terms of the screen time and excess screen time and all these things, they try to bring in their real life the propensity for violence, etc. Now, what does experiential learning do? So it's about demonstrating the practical usage of math, science, and other learning areas. They pursue and work through problems. It encourages children to come up with their own strategies, and they go through the collaborative effort of learning, and all important reality of failure comes into the picture, and they possibly will come out with ways to overcome them. Now also they find these are the ways to different ways to express social and emotional difficulties. Children can learn about social interaction, peer learning, and the concept of give and take between peers. Now, children can use role play in their play spaces, which mimic real life scenarios. They discover new concepts in engaging ways. Now, when children, they receive information by actively engaging with the subject at hand, rather than just being receiving passive information from the teacher. Most important, it triggers the internal curiosity of each child, which is something which most of the time the education system, what we've been following, kills that. Now, what is this project about? The project was for a chain of progressive schools who have adopted best practices from education systems from around the world. Now, the brief from the client was to create a self-exploratory activity area. And this was not a play zone. Now the age group was from 3 to 6 years. And these included both kindergarten classes and from the Montessori environment, because the chain of schools have both the choices for parents to choose from, whether it's a kindergarten system or a Montessori system. Now, the brief from the client was that the activity zone had to work away from the role of a teacher. So here the teacher was a provider or a facilitator. Okay. Now the teacher, the space and the products had to enable the exploratory learning processes, and it had to, processes of the Reggio Emilia philosophy had to be highlighted here. Now, as a design and build thing, the project had to be cost effective and it had to be within budgets. Just a small introduction about the Reggio Emilia system. It was started by Loris Malaguzzi after the World War in the Reggio Emilia region. And the community was so involved in the system and nurturing it, the system itself is named after the place where the whole thing began. What are the characteristic features of the system? Now, teacher has a dual role of a learner along with the children. Observation and document of both the teacher and child is emphasized in this system. Now, the classroom is considered as a third teacher, and emphasis is laid on the number of things which can become a teacher for the child. They're called as the 100 languages. Now, the children are encouraged to learn at their own pace. So they become active learners with teachers guiding them as mentors. The Reggio system talks about emphasizing and developing creativity, curiosity, and critical thinking. Now, this is one system which talks about community throughout. So it's a collaborative learning where teachers, parents, and community along with the children is consciously encouraged in the Reggio system. Now, what was our design approach? So it was to create a learning play system that includes a range of products where each one of them is a building block for a child's developmental need, which is intuitive as is self-guiding. Now, the system had to be open-ended. It had to be intuitive, experiential, and multisensorial. That was one important aspect which we put for ourselves. It should encourage collaboration, teamwork, and group learning. Now, the activity zone space itself had to lend itself to multiple usage opportunities for both teachers and children alike. The product had to be easy to use, store, mobility, maintenance, reconfiguration, and of course, it has to be it had to be child friendly. Now, the product had to be production, transport, and installation friendly. It had to be modular, cost effective. So now I want Ritu to take over the thing.
So I'll explain you all how this product really works. I mean, bringing our product design aspect into it and bringing how what the client really spoke about. And since we were equally involved in the whole production, it was really important for us to get into the nitty-gritties of it right from the making part of it and what is the learning role that it's playing in the child's engagement. So we kind of looked at what are the building blocks in a child's life in at least between 3 to 6 years of age. And we felt that these were some of the very basic things that the child needs. Is about numbers, is about narratives, about discovering, it's about nature, and also a freedom to explore and a freedom to where they can do what they want to do. I mean, there's been so much talking about in the earlier talks also about that. So we came up with a product where the base or the core, what we are talking about is the same, but what is really on top happening or what is coming in contact with the children is very, very different, and which is lending in a very intuitive way as to what the child's need is really. So if you see, I'll take you all through the thing. So we also created several supported accessories to create this experiential learning environment in this space, which kind of helped to the our whole core idea of what experiential learning is about. And so the whole thing was, say, the nature part of it, you know. So the nature part was about discovering, and or say the numeracy part of it. So I'll just explain you all through what each unit was about, you know. So if a space is there, each unit is about being able to reconfigure the space the way one wants it. So the mobility was a very important part. But yes, there were locks which were there to take care of it. Accessibility, safety, child draws, ergonomics for the 3 to 6 year old. And it was based on the collaborative learning, what we have been speaking about. So say 4 to 6 kids can easily hover around it to come together and play around this one hub was what our base concept was. So now if you really just see one of the tops of what we are talking about, the numeracy hub, is about an intuitive learning of about counting, sequencing, arranging. And since we had also got into developing these play equipments also, the play aids with it, so we were able to do more to it and not just leave it to the school or the teachers who were to do it. So we got into the furniture as well as the play aids of what we were actually conceptualizing. And this whole intuitive learning sort of was coming through because of this match of the play accessories and the furniture with it. So like say the Discovery Hub had a, you know, a light thing integrated in it, so that when the children are seeing it, they're seeing more beyond than what it's obviously looking. So you can see leaves through it, you can do tracing with it, you can have these acrylic things which are translucent kind, with which you can bring together several kind of silhouettes or shadow play or these kind of activities. So there were a whole lot of activities which could be done by children by creating this system. And similarly, the Multiplicity Hub was quite a surprise for us because they brought their own playthings and started using it in their own way. And we could see that they were collaborating or they just wanted to be alone also. And this was one interesting thing because it also kind of helped for these group explorations. It was people were like bringing the clay and all those things also to play in this space. And this was interesting because the surface what we created was something that they could draw on. So, you know, even the books were coming to life and building scenarios was happening, organizing ideas, myths, fables, storyboarding, all these aspects were actually happening. If you see the children interacting with it, they were quite happy being together, which was a fun thing to see. And one could see further that how even if they want to have a storytelling session, it was very easy to conduct around it. Or for that matter, the Nature Hub, you know, it had a certain quality of organizing things. So one actually encourages children to bring things from outside, you know, pick pebbles, pick bamboo, pick leaf, pick petals and all that, and can bring it together and organize it to share it with each other. And these were some of the other secondary things that we had brought part of it.
So coming to the conclusion, this tactile with a K learning system is an attempt to introduce products that address specific areas of preschool learning. Now, looking at the Reggio system, they do not have a rigid rules or evaluation methods to evaluate their approach. So that way it makes it very open-ended, and which allows additions, combinations to the products and be interchanged. They can be used for various learning objectives depending on the context of use and how the teacher directs them how to use it. And the product system's objective itself was to develop an activity zone that is free from the regular classroom and teacher-driven approach. Now, this, if you look at the product system, it's a very simple system. Now, it can be still be made part of the major schooling. It can be made accessible to the majority. Now, that means it has to get into our public schooling systems. And most important is to have trained teachers who can understand the importance of being observers. They can be triggers and guides for the young children than the regular role of a teacher. And the there's all important thing is to educate parents about the importance of experiential learning. And not only parents, the majority of the population, they need to understand the necessity for experiential learning for children in as many forms as possible, because day by day, the issues what we are tackling and complexities what we are tackling is increasing. The moment students start learning experientially, they straight away are understanding the problems. They can grow, explore, understand, and pursue their own interests. So this has been something which, as a studio production unit, we have been right from the day we started off, we've been talking about materiality and addressing issues of sustainability right from the beginning. And this really helped when we took up the project. So we'd like to show a small video.
Okay. Thank you. And if anybody have any questions from the audience, anyone has any questions from audience?
Are you looking at having this kind of a space only for the kindergartners and the primary classes, or would it also serve the slightly older children too?
This can be, since it's a very open-ended system, if like, for example, if the school asks us that this needs to be catered to a certain age group, we can increase or decrease the complexity in the system itself, but still keep it open-ended. Because at the end of the day, we want the teachers who are going to be the main facilitators to be comfortable with the system.
True. Right. So it's like an adaptable one, depending
upon the age. It should be adaptable. Right. That way, the Reggio system itself is so open-ended about what they define as prerequisites. It's amazing, I think, what we learned during the project.
Yeah. I think it's a lovely space that you created. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
What about the cost and availability of the products?
So this is one project which we have done because from the past 15 years, we've been doing these kind of very special projects, which does not form as a mass thing. But any institutional project, for that matter, it's always in a tight budget. So the product, what we have done, it was very tight in terms of the wastage of the materials and all those things. We had to really keep a tight leash on it. So again, if based on the client's requirements and budgets, we can always specifically custom make it.
Sure. Thank you.